Hello and welcome to City Edition, the City of Bend's video news magazine. I'm Justin Feinstone. Bend's wastewater treatment plant is at capacity and on tap for expansion, but city staff is looking for ways to maximize the efficiency of existing components. Take a look.
The City of Bend has done a series of projects over the last 6 years, looking at what we can do to provide more treatment in the area and the tanks that we have right now, and be more efficient with more sustainable, energy efficient means. Capacity wise at the wastewater treatment plant, we can treat 6 million gallons per day. Right now, we're just under 6 million gallons per day on an average basis. So we've been planning additional capacity improvements, as well as trying to do more with what we have. In order to accomplish this upgrade, we've put together a team of design engineers with CH2M Hill and WH Pacific, and a team from the City of Bend of engineers, operators, maintenance staff, and looked at ways that we can economize and more efficiently treat this wastewater in what we have, the existing plant that we have. How much, you know, how well can we use the existing tankage and facilities that we have?
Our team helped the city through a selection process that selected IFast Technology, which is integrated fixed film activated sludge. And essentially we're going to take many truckloads of these plastic media and put them into a new compartment within each of the existing aeration basins. And a biofilm will grow on the media, and that will provide a very high efficiency treatment process that will improve the efficiency of the basins. By adding the IFast carrier media in the aeration basins, we're able to treat more in two aeration basins as the city is currently treating in three. So this improvement in efficiency will really serve the city well and also allows for expandability in the future.
The biofilm, or the bacteria that live on these bug condos or IFast media, require lots of air. And by adding more capacity to the wastewater plant, we're going to need more air. And that is the largest user of energy at our wastewater plant. So with the idea that we want to reduce our costs, operating costs, we're putting in turbo blowers. It's a new technology that allows us to reduce the energy requirement by 30% and thus our energy bills.
We're here at the city's existing chlorine contact basins right next to the gas chlorine storage facility. This process will be replaced by a new ultraviolet disinfection facility to treat the wastewater before it leaves the plant. The ultraviolet disinfection process is much safer and allows the city to avoid hauling in chlorine from over the mountains. Another way we are increasing efficiency is related to the recently completed digester mixing project. The digester takes sludge from the liquids process and cooks it in these tanks behind us, allowing the city to dispose of it safely. The digester mixing project improved mixing in the two older digesters, allowing the city to put more solids in those digesters and defer capital investment of a fourth digester tank for 10 to 20 years.
Another benefit to the digester mixing project was to allow us to produce more methane gas. That methane gas feeds boilers and heats the water that heats our buildings. And the expansion project will capitalize on that heat. And all the buildings will be heated by this methane gas. Saves us energy, reduces our monthly bills.